Have you ever wondered how vulnerable Wi-Fi security was back in the 90s? Welcome back, Tech Sky enthusiasts. Today we're diving into the fascinating topic of cybersecurity with a practical demonstration. Remember, this is purely for educational purposes. If you find this intriguing, please like, subscribe, and share it with your friends. Let's embark on this exciting journey into the realm of cybersecurity. Step 1. Switch the wireless interface to monitor mode. I've explained this step in many of my previous videos. If you're already familiar with it, feel free to skip ahead to the next step. For those new to this, let's go through it in detail. First, we need to switch our wireless interface to monitor mode. Monitor mode allows us to capture all wireless traffic in our vicinity, making it crucial for our ARP replay attack. Let's begin by checking the current mode of our wireless interface. Open your terminal and run the command iwconfig. This command displays the current configuration of your wireless interfaces. You'll likely see that your wireless interface is set to managed mode, which is the default mode for regular Wi-Fi use. Before switching to monitor mode, we need to get the MAC address of our wireless interface. Run the command ifconfig wlan0. Here, wlan0 is the name of our wireless interface. This command will display detailed information about the interface, including the MAC address. Note down this address, as we'll need it later in our process. Now, let's switch our interface to monitor mode. Start by bringing the interface down, ifconfig wlan0 down. This command disables the wireless interface, preparing it for the mode switch. Next, we need to terminate any processes that might interfere with the switch. Use the command ermongcheckkill. This command ensures that no other processes are using the wireless interface. At this point, your Wi-Fi connection will be temporarily disconnected. Next, switch the wireless interface to monitor mode by running iwconfig wlan0 mode monitor. This command changes the mode of the interface from manage to monitor. To bring the interface back up and enable monitor mode, run ifconfig wlan0 up. Now, verify the mode change by running iwconfig again. You should now see that the wireless interface is set to monitor mode. Great. We've successfully switched our wireless interface to monitor mode. This setup allows us to capture and analyze wireless traffic, setting the stage for our ARP replay attack. Step 2. Perform a fake authentication attack. In the last step, we successfully switched our wireless interface to monitor mode. Now, we need to perform a fake authentication attack to associate our device with the target network. If you're familiar with this process from our previous video, feel free to skip ahead to step 3. For those who need a refresher, let's dive in. First, we need to identify our target network. We'll start by scanning for nearby Wi-Fi networks. Open your terminal and run /etc/wlan0. This command will display all the Wi-Fi networks in your vicinity, along with their details, including the BSSID and the channel number. Look for our target network, TechSky, which is a WEP encrypted network. Once you've identified the target network, note down its BSSID and channel number. We need these details to focus our attack on this specific network. Next, we'll refine our scan to target only TechSky. Run the following command, /etc/ngbssid, write the MAC address of the target network here. Channel, write the channel number here on which the target network operates. Write, saves the captured data into a file named ARP replay for later use. wlan0 indicates the name of our wireless interface in monitor mode. Press enter to execute the command. You'll see that currently, there are no devices connected to the TechSky network. This is because we haven't performed the fake authentication attack yet. Now, let's perform the fake authentication attack. This attack will make the access point believe that our device is a legitimate client, allowing us to inject packets. Run the following command, /ngfakoth6000, which specifies the fake authentication attack with a reassociation delay of 6000 seconds. 01 indicates the number of authentication requests to send, in this case 1. A, which specifies the MAC address of the target network. H specifies the MAC address of our wireless interface. wlan0 indicates the name of our wireless interface in monitor mode. Press enter to execute the command. The terminal will show that the fake authentication attack is in progress. Once it's successful, our device will be authenticated with the network. Now, switch back to the terminal, where we are running aerodump-ng. You should see that the auth column now shows OPN, indicating an open authentication, and our device appears as a connected client on the network. Great job. We've successfully performed a fake authentication attack. This sets the stage for our next step, the ARP replay attack. Stay tuned as we dive into step 3, where we will generate and capture ARP requests to crack the WEP key. Step 3. Perform an ARP replay attack. In the previous steps, we switched our wireless interface to monitor mode and performed a fake authentication attack. Now it's time to perform the ARP replay attack. This is the exciting part where we'll generate and capture ARP packets to eventually crack the WEP key. To begin the ARP replay attack, open your terminal and run the following command, airplay-ng arp-replay, which specifies the ARP replay attack mode, b, which indicates the MAC address of the target network, h, specifies the MAC address of your wireless interface, WLAN0 refers to the name of your wireless interface in monitor mode. You'll notice that it begins to capture and replay ARP packets. This process is crucial because it generates a high volume of traffic, which helps in collecting the necessary initialization vectors required to crack the WEP key. However, this process can take some time, as it depends on the amount of traffic generated and captured. For demonstration purposes, I'm going to terminate this process prematurely due to time constraints. But in a real scenario, you should let it run to collect as many packets as possible, especially ARP packets, to ensure the success of the attack. Once you've collected enough packets, we can proceed to crack the WEP key. Open the file manager and navigate to the directory where your capture file is saved. Confirm the name of your capture file. In this example, the file name is arpreplay-01.cap. Now, let's use aircrack-ng to decrypt the packets and retrieve the WEP key. Run the following command, aircrack-ng arpreplay-01.cap. Aircrack-ng will start processing the captured packets. It attempts to decrypt the packets to extract the WEP key. However, because I didn't collect enough packets in the previous step, the process is likely to fail. As you can see, aircrack-ng displays a message indicating that it needs at least 5,000 IVs to succeed. This means you need to be patient and let the ARP replay attack run longer to gather the required amount of data. Remember, this video is a demonstration of the process. In practice, you should allow enough time to collect sufficient packets to ensure a successful attack. Thank you for watching. If you found this tutorial helpful, please like, subscribe, and share it with your friends. In the next video, we'll move on to cracking our next encryption method, WPA. Stay tuned for more ethical hacking tutorials and keep exploring the fascinating world of cybersecurity. Until next time, stay curious and stay secure.